we're using story time now before the recording starts.
Well, too bad. I just pressed the start recording button.
All right, damn now it. Time to retread all the stories we just talked about. First, we're going to talk about that time that I pants chaps in front of all of the girls in high school.
Yeah, that's
thing. No, not my pants.
Well, we need them. Now give us your other pants.
Now give us other pants.
No. Give me your other pants. Give me your pants.
That's why I wear suspenders.
I was wearing suspenders, and then they hurt my back, so then I stopped wearing suspenders.
I've never worn suspenders in my life.
I like suspenders because I can't hold my pants up all day, and I hate belts.
Yeah, belts kind of suck.
I'd rather just hang myself with a belt than wear it.
I mean, you're kind of wearing it, but now you're wearing it around your neck.
Yeah.
So, huh. Hmm. Anyway, well, we're playing 9 Hours, but... 9 Persons, 9 Doors.
Hi.
Hello.
One of my favorite fucking visual novels that these I super strong-armed you guys into playing with me.
I mean, I was okay with playing it to start with. I own
Virtue. No, you hated it. You hated it, and you hate me, and you didn't want to do this.
No, sure no, Chaps is right.
Anyway, he's Phantom. I'm an unnamed character, and this is Mary.
Aha!
Except that... I'm glad that when we were going to do that thing for the page read-throughs, that was like, hey, we're going to make sure that Trevor's name is not known for as long as possible, and then halfway through the first episode, we just started using my name and just...
Look.
That plan went out the window.
You ruined your gimmick.
Okay. No. The thing is, you're telling me to not use your name. The guy who can't like fucking keep things straight even for 5 minutes in his head.
And I think the best part is you introduced me with my name after spending an entire other recording session not calling me that name.
Exactly. That's why I still use Chaps, because I can't. It's already been ingrained.
Like, again, like, I'm not trying to do it to misgender you. I'm just... You're challenging
the
start button.
I know.
You know how long it took for me to start calling Quill Brandon?
I don't like it when people call Quill Brandon. It weirds me out.
Exactly.
I'm glad they told
the
us this.
The first time I said, hey, Brandon, he actually took a fucking double take.
No, yeah, it's actually important. So, I played the original DS version. I haven't actually played the Nonary Games version, so I don't know what the actual gameplay difference is, given there's no longer two screens.
Well, I mean, wasn't this available on other consoles as well?
We'll see.
Well, the Nonary Games version, yes, but the original... Like, the Nonary Games collection is, but the original 999 was DS exclusive.
I see.
Then Virtue's Last Reward was on the 3DS and the PS Vita.
Mmm. Glad we're on Titanic.
And then Zero Time Dilemma was on Steam, Vita, and 3DS.
I see.
Oh man, this is gonna fuck up the recording. Yeah. Uh-oh.
Yeah, is it just eating shit? Is that what happened?
No, I had to tab over to Skype just to turn you Chuckle Fucks down a little bit because I realized how fucking loud you are.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. Oh no!
And then the Titanic sank. Game over. Roll credits.
Mm.
Turns out the first puzzle was hidden in the opening cutscene, and we failed. It was a one-time only. It deletes the game from our system.
How'd you know?
I'm good at picking these things out.
Alright, so here's something I can figure out the UI with you guys, because...
Junpei! What? The worst character in Persona 3.
I have never played Persona 3, so I have no horse in that race.
It's generally liked, but it's got some problems that are fixed in later games. Mostly that you can't control the characters. Ah. You know, thing kind of fundamental to being an RPG.
Shit.
Like, imagine if you could only control your starter Pokemon and all your other Pokemon just did whatever the fuck they wanted.
What? Whoa! So it's like the weird Yokai Watch effect.
Probably, I don't know.
Yeah, Yokai Watch is fun. I need to buy the game again.
I'm good.
Ooh. God damn it! Ah, what the hell? A bed?
A bed?
Something tells me that he didn't realize that he bought a ticket to the Titanic.
That really hurts.
What, are you telling me you don't yearly go on a trip on the Titanic?
Well, I'm a lich, so I kind of do, but for business, not pleasure.
Here, what happens if you click on the little rotatey thing up there? Where, up top right. What happens if you click on that?
Advanced screen?
Whoa. Oh, okay.
Oh.
That's interesting.
An earthquake.
Okay, I see. So that's how they handle the two-screen problem.
Mm-hmm.
I'm making it one screen. Anyway.
So does that mean that we're does it just change the way that the text is presented to us? Or are we, like, missing narration?
No idea.
Am I?
Kind of...
It appears to just flip between two different ways to present the text. One's more of a novel sense, one's more of a visual novel sense. Oh, and the shaking stopped.
Wait, it stopped?
I'm already seeing puzzle elements.
Okay. It's been a while since I played the original 999, so I can't say what the text originally looked like. Sorry.
Okay.
C'est la vie.
I see a suitcase. Imagine once we get out of the novel, it'll, five.
That's...
written in five. Blood.
What's this five mean?
What does this five mean? Please explain this five more.
That five's not...
won't open. What's this? Is this...
I thought those were, like, spooky Cthulhus for a second.
It might be.
It might be Cthulhu's. Hey, I don't know that.
Hello? Is anyone there? Open the door.
Gonna go with your proper fuck, kiddo.
Yeah, I was gonna say, why do people always scream at locked doors? It's like, let me out. Well, someone put you in here while you were unconscious and locked the door. Yeah, it's like, oh, sorry, didn't realize you were still in there.
Yep, that's five again.
A watch.
Maybe switch over to the novel side.
I wish it didn't have that annoying transition effect.
Okay. I like having the extra little fluff narration. Is all.
That's the same as the door.
It's a video game. It has a visual element. We can see.
This man has some strong reasoning.
How do I take this off? Maybe pushing something on this will work?
Nope, it just triggers your death.
Damn.
Guess let's see, just push the two buttons on the side and it immediately explodes.
Taking my hand with it.
How much Soaperville bait are we talking about here, chaps?
About a few.
No good. This stupid thing won't come off.
Yeah, we are actually missing a lot of narration with this.
Yeah, see, that's why I was saying maybe it's a good idea to stick on the novel side.
That's kind of annoying. Alright, well.
Yeah, it's like I said, that's one of the things that weirded me out when I heard that they were going to have the adventure mode. I mean, I guess I can see the adventure mode being for people who, like, only want to, like, who want to kind of breeze through it, but why would you want to breeze through a visual novel?
Because I want to breeze through a visual novel. I have places to be, damn it.
Got shit to do.
Where am I?
Yeah, this would be a little different without the narration, that's for sure.
Oh, now he starts questioning.
Why?
I feel like they don't need to say Junpei in every line. Like, I feel like if there was another character, you can say it then, but otherwise you're just kind of wasting text space.
Spooky.
Ooh. My head.
I don't think it did that in the DS game. I feel like it had little earth, little name text boxes somewhere. I can't remember. I'll download a ROM to refresh my memory.
Junpei, I am your angel of death.
No, we'll get to that.
Yeah, we'll get to that. Don't worry.
For context, to all the three of us currently playing, who might be watching in the future, we just got finished watching Batman Mask of the Phantasm.
No.
It was pretty good. Movie.
I hated it.
It was pretty good. It's true. Tom hated it. He was voicing his displeasure the entire time.
Thick Impenetrable Darkness, my favorite.
A mirror. I'm sure that won't be important.
That's a porthole.
It's super important.
Well, it's kind of reflective, isn't it?
Yes, it's reflective. Most glass is. Thank you.
Wait. Also, just quit. Is there voice acting going?
Absolutely.
Alright, neat.
Oh, well, then we've stopped hearing the game audio.
Yeah, because it's not particularly loud.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Fair enough.
Gotcha.
Uh-oh.
Well,
what the hell is going on here?
Yep, that's
I'll just strong-arm Trevor into watching the videos with me later so he can hear the music.
Make me.
It's real good music.
I send you cool videos and you're like, eh, I'll probably never actually watch this. But I'm also going to strong-arm Trevor into watching stuff.
I've watched a lot of the videos you've sent me. Right, I've been going back...
Did you watch the How to Play Magic video?
I have got started on it.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell? God damn it!
We're gonna die.
Yeah, we're gonna super die.
Are you? Okay, you might be in danger of dying.
Well, better just keep banging on the door.
Yeah. I mean, anyone? When it comes down to it, there? This guy is going to live or die due to our problem-solving skills, so, really, that's just a death sentence.
Say something.
Maybe interact with the puzzle.
No. I gotta stare at this key card slot.
I can't imagine what opens the door. Man, you're already ankle deep. You wasted a significant amount of time.
Not good. Not good at all. Okay. I need to find a way out, and fast.
Now, I know in Virtue's Last Reward I haven't hit any timed puzzles. Are there timed puzzles in this one, chap?
I don't know. Why don't you keep playing and find out?
I'm not the one playing, so I can't find out.
Tom, why don't you keep playing so Trevor can find out?
Give me a dollar.
Yeah, here we go!
Anime!
No. I'd rather sit here and die.
The answer is not to remove any sense of tension, but no, there are no timed puzzles in this.
Alright.
See, because I'm not an asshole, I'm not gonna say that this room is time to fuck with you guys like a certain other friend that I knew did.
Yeah, I moved pretty frantically the first time I went through the first puzzle in Virtue's Last Reward. It's like, oh no, the elevator's gonna drop, and no, that was just a fucking lie.
Alright, so, Thomas, have you ever played like one of those point-and-click escape the room games?
Absolutely.
Newgrounds? So, yeah, that welcome to the game.
I do like that.
This is one of those point-and-click escape the room games.
Puzzles.
Okay, I would like to press the key now. Thank you.
I think. Oh, it highlights interactables. That's actually a really good time saver, because it doesn't do that in virtual and VLR.
Yeah, it also didn't do it in the original games, though. You guys are lucky. I just had to fucking blindly tap on everything.
That's my current life in DLR. because I'm a fucking loser who plays games out of order.
Because you're a huge fucking nerd.
We've got a screwdriver. Quick, unscrew the fucking card reader.
Screwdriver, huh? I know what that's.
That's not what I wanted. Wanted the pillow behind it. Alright, well. You got this thing over here.
Okay,
this is gonna be color coordinated, so let me just do something really quick.
Is the blue turned off on your screen?
Yes.
Oh, no.
No, it's okay. I turned it off. I turned it off.
I believe there are some objects you can rotate. It might be in the next game, not this one. I can't remember. I feel like you can rotate.
It's satanics.
Action! They didn't do anything. All right. Yes, combining, yes. Mm-hmm. Yep, thank you. Alright. Well, we got this thing. Hold on. Freaking man. Hell next to sink. Okay, guess I just won't take it at all.
Oh, I thought that was a knife.
Let's see if we can equip the water. Nope.
You have to seek a way out.
Man, it's weird how I've been in here for this long and the water is still staying at the same level.
Shut up. Damn it, I didn't want to click that again.
You really wanted to click on that.
Hey!
Hey!
Ah!
A thingamadoo.
Search. Well, could it be a...
So the inverse of the other one. We'll look for you later. Anything under the bed? Alright, well, that you were a great help.
Yeah, what's up with this? Oh!
There's another key.
A key! Now what are we gonna do with the key?
I figure out what we need to do. We need the blue key.
Man, I'm an anime.
Oh, Junpei, you're not looking good. I look like a zombie. You're not looking good there, buddy.
What's up with my face?
What the hell happened to me?
Oh, you got hit in the head with a pipe.
I left work, headed back to my apartment, and...
and fucking died.
There was this pig lady, and, like, then I was here.
Uh-oh.
I'm back. Not like anyone will respond.
Oh no, backstory.
Might be some backstory.
Look at that JPEG.
Man, work was rough today.
That's just straight up like a Katawa Shoujo like JPEG.
They got that off of Google Images.
A breeze.
Breeze?
A breeze, yeah, that's how open windows work.
That's weird. Did I leave that open?
Sometimes, yes, I suppose.
Everything looks okay.
I forgot about that window.
Oh my god, the phantasm's in here. It's your angel of death, Junpei. Get out.
Oh god, it is.
Oh my god, it is.
Hello, Junpei. I'd like to play a game.
What?
I heard you don't quite appreciate your ass meat. Let's fix that.
Just keep this guy of memes out of here.
Only Disgaea memes?
Only Batman memes allowed here.
What do you mean Disgaea memes?
You brought that up in the Disgaea LP. Yeah.
Consider this a privilege. You have been chosen. I knew, chap. I was seeing if you knew.
See, I don't know because I don't remember anything from like, any point in my life.
Said that's the word, boys, we're in!
Roll credits!
Fine, that theme plays.
Oh yeah, that did happen.
That guy with the gas mask.
Oh yeah.
That son of a bitch must have taken me here. get my hands on him. Well, I guess
when I get my hands on him, he'll probably just hit me with a pipe again.
Well, I guess there's no way to know if that was a man or not. Guess I shouldn't be pointing any fingers just immediately.
Who was that?
Again, it's
they said you have been chosen. What the hell is going on?
Junpei. You killed my father, Junpei.
Said the word again!
Roll credits! Again!
Also, it also notice that it's a stand.
Yeah, it's kind of a stand.
Roll credits, but with feeling this game.
Dude, combine, Captain Kyoraku's, Zanpakuto toe with an actual stand, and that'd probably just be what the Nonary Games looks like.
Kinda.
I'm gonna pretend I understood any word you said.
Yeah, well, that's life.
Mr. Hat Kimono Man from Bleach.
Mr. Hat Kimono.
Oh, yeah.
Because you might not have seen it yet, but his Zanpakuto allows him to instill the fight with the rules of children's games.
Neat.
Like, one of the ones he uses later on during the Blood War arc is the Japanese version of Red Light, Green Light.
That's amazing.
And one that he uses a lot more often is the Step on Your Shadow game.
Ooh.
Oh, Lord.
I wonder if we have... Oh, yeah, so, okay, actually, that's a feature that they implemented into this game from Virtue's Last Reward. Yeah, so in the original game, as many visual novels have, there are routes in this game. But if you wanted to do the other routes, you had to start a completely new game, yeah. And you'd have to redo rooms that you'd already finished.
Yeah, that's...
So I think them implementing the flowchart thing is going to make this off. Hell of a lot better.
All right.
If not, a hell of a lot quicker.
So I'm thinking that we need to operate the keys in accordance to the cards. And if this is anything like VLR, then there are two solutions to the safe that give us different rewards.
We should probably investigate the items in our inventory. We may have some things that we can combine. You know, that mechanic that they explained.
Yeah, they did explain it.
Yeah, can we use a screwdriver on that? Picture of an old cruise liner. Hey.
All right.
Now, does this have a memo pad feature?
Potential. I am not too sure.
Because that's probably my favorite feature in Virtue's Last Reward is just having a memo pad I can jot down notes on, because it saves me from having to memorize / constantly tab over to my fucking items.
I don't know. Is there a memo button, Thumb?
Didn't look like it. There's a calc, whatever that is.
Calculator?
Yeah, I'm pressing it, but it's not bringing it up.
Oh, it's probably gonna pull it up when we actually need to use a calculator.
Yeah, I'm imagining.
All right, so pull up the key.
Here, do you want me to get pen and paper to write it down? Because I have it right at my feet.
So what I'm thinking is that we have to switch keys mid combination somehow. If that's how it wants us to do it.
Well, remember, we have two different notes here, each with four symbols on it, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we also, on the back of the picture of the Titanic, we have a thing that translates the numbers to...
Yeah, no, I get that part. Unless we just have to use both notes in tandem and then insert the blue part with the blue part and the red part with the red part. Yeah, it must be we have to do that. Alright. Oh, is it not gonna let us pull it up? Mid...
Nope!
Salt. Ah.
Okay.
That's
Just remember, we have the blue key in the chest. So let's see.
Solid square.
Look at the two notes because we can see each one.
Yeah. So solid square, hollow and triangle,
facing up,
and then solid triangle facing down. Then solid triangle or hollow triangle facing the other way. So let's go.
If anything, you can still get a look at the things from the little mini icon there.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. So
solid triangle, a hollow triangle facing left is 2, and hollow triangle facing right is 3. So the second digit is 2, and the last digit is 3.
All right.
You got that written down, Trevor?
0, 2, 6, 3.
Okay. 0. Yeah. Come on. 0, 2, 6, 3. Hey, I think it did it.
Huh.
Aha! All right, let's open her up. We did it. Got a file.
Alright. So yeah, if this works anything like the other game, then there's 2 solutions. So if we come back to the chest and do red, we're gonna get another thing.
Digital root. Oh boy.
See, this is why the game gave us a calculator.
Yeah. Okay, at the very least I know how to do digital roots.
I hope you like digital roots. It might be a recurring theme, who knows?
Okay. Yeah, I know how to final digit is used.
I think the original game gave a calculator too. I think. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't have been able to beat it.
Yeah, thank you. Going above my head.
It's really simple. It's just I don't really see the point of digital roots because. I was never taught that in school, but supposedly they taught my younger brother brother that when he went through the same school. And a stack of key cards. Looks like some key cards.
See,
6, 7, 8. Does that mean anything?
6, 7, 8. Do we still have that red key?
We do still have that red key.
All right. So pull up the Titanic. One? Okay.
Give me a second. It's still going through the massive tutorial here.
Yeah, this is the tutorial puzzle, so.
Yeah, we
It enters in a sequence. It's not a double line. It's not like a double.
I know.
Quick, enter 8008. Boom. Oh my god.
Find the digital root. Four!
Digital root of boobies is 4. Alright.
Alright.
Let us go.
Alright. Let's try that.
Alright.
It's a pipe. You got it.
Oh, Junpei? Okay.
I fucking love Junpei. If you inspect things multiple times, sometimes there's different dialogue.
Man,
this could be important later on.
Man, when I was going through VLR the first time, I was like, man, I really hope that Sigma's not just like a fucking bland, emotionless, uninteresting protagonist, and then he started like actually just hitting on the women. It's like, okay, you at least got something going on.
I love, like, out of all the main pro tags in the Zero Escape series, Sigma is my favorite, but I love them all.
They're all pretty good. Figgy and Fido, though.
Oh boy, Tom, I can't wait until you can meet Figgy and Fido.
We'll see.
Listen. I really hope that there's a condescending AI in this game, too, who calls all the characters by dumb nicknames.
Did you know that that AI is voiced by Amy Rose?
Oh.
That's a fun fact.
Of Sonic fame?
Yes.
Yeah, I can hear that.
Already found everything in there, so...
And now there's a green key!
Oh, thanks.
No, better yet, a purple key. You gotta combine it. Is there no way to... Oh, okay, there we go. Oh, it's a mirror.
Yeah.
Yeah, is there no way to interact with the suitcase again?
Put on, like, actually, you need to try clicking on the key so you can have it in your toolbar.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Try putting the key in your toolbar.
Yeah, no. Because it specified that this was a blue suitcase. So I'm assuming that's important. I really gotta stop.
Oh, okay.
As I mentioned before the recording, I played 999 long ago that I still remember all the plot details, but barely any of the gameplay. So I'm kind of just, other than some vague idea of how to do some solutions, I'm just in the dark as you guys are.
I mean, that's good.
So
that's
the roots
the
is
like
what's
it.
Gonna lead. So the roots is what's gonna lead us. The George is what's going to lead us to getting out of the door.
Yeah, here's your tips menu, by the way.
Yeah.
So there must be a red suitcase somewhere that gives us our optional stuff for the...
That's what I would imagine.
That is a thing, right, Chips?
That is a mechanic in Virtue's Last Reward. What you're thinking of the file thing where you get lore rewards as files. That is not the case in this game.
Okay, so then we actually just have extra material to an unknown solution.
Can you try clicking on the blue key?
I actually tried that earlier, and
it actually just...
I'm clicking right now.
It. Weird. Maybe there's something we can do with the...
Oh, you know what? Maybe this is a turning point for, if we had done the red, maybe we have ended up going on a different story path.
No, if you look at the flow, the split's not until here.
Just like Virtue's Last Reward, that it's gonna, like, it'll show you the points where there are divergences.
Wow, this is already more labyrinthine than VLR, though.
It's not as bad as VLR, trust me.
Like, VLR doesn't seem to be labyrinthine until you find out that you have to go on certain... You have to finish certain paths before you can come back.
Try interacting with the pad again. Maybe there's something we can do here.
Yeah, hit the red. Maybe something will open up on the thing. When we do the routes. I don't think I've got enough cards.
So
okay,
we do have these cards, and they were specifically labeled, I think, 6, 7, and 8. So I'm assuming they're telling us to do, like, the digital route of 6, 7, and 8. So let's give it a shot. 3. Okay. Good to know. Actually, hold on. Let me actually check to make sure that that is correct.
So, okay.
6 through 8, yes.
Maybe there's something that we haven't searched yet, because we have our blue suitcase. Maybe there's some like obscure thing we haven't tapped on.
So that this is just a mirror. That is not the button I wanted to press. We already did this. That's where we got the first memo. There's nothing in the sink. I've clicked on that many times.
Did we fuck with everything on the in the stove there?
Did we click on the Did we click on the thing past the stove? Because that looks like a fucking closet. See what I mean?
Okay, hold on. First off, before the obvious.
There you go.
Before the obvious.
Like I said, maybe when in doubt, this is literally just like any other escape the room game, when in doubt, just fucking click everything.
When in doubt, pinkies out. Okay, before we go in, let's decipher.
Yeah, now that you know that it's not going to let you look at the code,
yeah,
let's figure things out. So, it looks like...
So, starting with this one.
Yes, so...
Okay, so we have second number four, last number five. Okay, so it is... 7 4 4 8 5 7 4 8 5
Sounds good.
Thank God my brain is good at remembering number strings.
Yosha.
That's how I remember my social security number. I stared at it until it's just permanently engraved in the back of my skull. Same with my credit card number, which is kind of worse for not spending money.
We did it.
Yosha!
Hell, I still remember my old credit card number, not that it does any good.
Ah.
Hey!
More key cards!
Let's see.
There's a number on each one. One, two, three.
Okay, I would almost wonder if the order on the cards mattered too, but I'm not thinking of it.
Let's see. And don't forget, you can use search on things to get a few different lines of dialogue on them.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Or perhaps not everything gives additional dialogue, but I know some things do.
Yeah, don't think I'm gonna need this again. So saith he. Couldn't take the hangers earlier, so. Alright, let's give her a shot.
So now we have the key cards in hand. Yeah, let's take it over to the pad and see what we need to do.
Start with those. The files. Files said something about a digital route. There's a route of five. That would literally just be five.
Well, here's the thing.
Cards that give us the digital root of five. Gotcha.
Yeah, we need to make the math problem.
Okay.
We have the solution. We need the question.
Okay, so...
So, that's not what three numbers... Yeah, so, since we can't put... We can go back out and pull up the calculator... So, what three numbers are we going to, out of 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, is going to give us a digital root of 5?
So, explain the digital root thing, because we kind of flashed out.
Okay, so basically what a digital root is, so say we have a number, 245. So we add up 2, 4, and 5, we get 11, I believe. Yeah, 11. But we're still not down to a single digit. So then we add 1 and 1, then we get 2. So the digital root of 245 is 2.
The gameplay just crashed. Oh, I heard Thomas.
Oh, there okay. I'm glad that we all just crashed.
So we cut out. Yeah, you win, Robot-y, for us.
Yeah, I'm super glad that you guys cut out just long enough to miss my entire explanation.
Yep.
It's okay. Now do it again with feeling this stuff.
Okay, so 245 digital root 2. All right, cool. That's exactly what I thought. Right. Anyway, so... Let's see. That already gives us 6. So let's see here. Where? 2. Close.
So yeah. So Troy, the basic idea is if you take the I'm just gonna read this verbatim from this thing I have pulled up. If you take the digits of any number and add them together, then add the digits of the resulting number together and continue to do that until you get a single digit. That single digit is the digital root of the original number. And then the example is so the digital root of 9 is 9. The digital root of 18 is 1 plus 8, which is 9. The digital root of 711 is 7 plus 1 plus 1 equals 9. You kind of get it?
I'm following.
You're essentially adding, you separate all the digits into an individual number and add them together to find the digital root.
Okay.
So out of 1, 2, 3, and 6, 7, 8, which of these numbers, when added together, are going to give us 5?
Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8. So the easiest thing would be to pick numbers that simplify. Okay.
167.
Didn't even give me a chance to.
Look, I was brute forcing it.
Explain your logic. Explain your logic, though, Trevor. Explain your logic.
Well, I was saying, like, we just need to find a way to make the fewest steps possible. So trying to find solutions that would break down the fastest.
Yep.
Okay.
So yeah, get used to doing digital root problems, because this is far from the last.
All right, we did it.
Nothing keeping me in except the water pressure building on the door.
Yep, it only took us about half an hour to do this.
That's the most miserable flow ever.
We did it.